Hello, gardening friends. I'm John Dromgoole. Well, you may have seen them out there at the nurseries. They've been around for a couple of years. Actually, they've been around since the 1920s. The Japanese and the Koreans have been doing something called grafting with the vegetables. And I brought some of them. Tomatoes are one of the more popular ones being grafted. You know, one of the things that happens is you get 4 to 5 times more production, 4 to 5 times more production on these grafted tomatoes than you would on the standard one. And so the graft is an important part of this whole thing because it has another root system that is more vigorous, and that's where this quality comes from in the production of more tomatoes. Some of the heirloom varieties are being grafted because you've probably grown them and seen that production isn't all that great. The quality of the vegetable is fine, the quality of the tomatoes are fine, but the production just isn't there. Something like this costs around $10. But then you get much more other qualities to them, like disease resistance. I've grown these in the past and tested them a couple times before they came onto the market, and they were fantastic. I really did find these to be very different than what we've been doing for many years. And so I'm real impressed by this. We tried some other varieties a few years ago, and they didn't do as well as these newer ones that are coming out. They're good-looking plants, and when you look at them, you'll see that the disease resistance is there. You won't see hardly a yellow leaf on them at all. And if you've grown tomatoes before, you've seen that pretty soon you get early blight or late blight, some of these problems, and I haven't witnessed them on there. So the value comes in with that also. You don't have to be out there spraying. One of the other qualities that several other types of tomatoes have is that nematodes are not a problem. Nematodes attack the root system and really take the vigor out of some of these plants. So we have increased longer production right into the extreme conditions of the summertime, and even poor soils. They do better in the poor soils in these extremely well-built gardens, which is fine. I think that that's an important thing to do in the garden anyway. And when you do that, production is really far up there. So whether it's an eggplant, tomato, or peppers, take a look at these peppers. This is a young plant right here, and it is full of peppers already. So that's really a quality that is very observable. The tomatoes will come along and in the heat just grow like you've not seen others produce before. The taste of these tomatoes is really superior. Production, 4 to 5 times more. I think you begin to see the value of a tomato, a pepper, or an eggplant that is much more productive. Insect and disease resistance, yes, insects don't attack these as much as you've seen on some of the other ones in your garden. I would really encourage you to try them. They do very well. You'll be impressed when you start. Try the tomatoes first, and you're going to see the high quality of the production in these plants. So grafting is something that's new, and I think a very important thing to be doing. For Backyard Basics, I'm John Dromgoole. I'll see you next time.